Today everyone, in this video, I will show you how to administer wound dressing. Wound dressing is very important to reduce the risk of infection and help the wound heal quickly and reduce from scarring. And before that, we need to perform hand hygiene, considering that I'm done hand washing and I'm wearing the PPEs needed. Then, I will collect the materials that I need. And these are the materials that we need in wound dressing. The hydrogen peroxide, betadine, the micropore, the gauze pad, sterile gloves, and clean gloves, and container with cotton balls with solution, scissors, and the forceps. Then I will proceed to the patient. Hello, Sir Jacob Brian Rabanal. I'm your healthcare staff for today. Nandito po ako, sir, para polinisan yung sugat nyo. Sir, patingin nga po ng sugat nyo, sir. Ayan po ba yung sugat nyo, sir? Medyo maliit naman, sir. Pero, nilinisan po natin para po hindi siya ma-infection. Okay lang po sa inyo, sir. Hindi naman po ito masakit, sir. Then, assess the patient and place gauze pad to stop the bleeding and elevate. Sige lang po, sir. Ilagay ko lang po ito para po ma-stop yung bleeding. Then, elevate. Then, when the bleeding stop, you can proceed to the cleaning of the wounds. Then, discard. Then, consider that in cleaning the wounds, you must use preferably running water and soap. But considering that there's no available running water, then clean it with the antiseptic solution. Remove foreign object if necessary, except for embedded object. Then change gloves from clean gloves to sterile gloves. Considering that I change my gloves, then to use the antiseptic solution to clean the wound of the patient. Okay, sir. Ilinisan lang po natin. In cleaning the wound, apply antiseptic solution using cotton balls in circular motion from the outer part of the wound to the wound itself. Okay, sir, hindi naman po ito masakit. Then, discard. Then, discard. The wound itself. Okay, sir. Then, put betadine. Lagyan lang po. Repeat the process from the outer part to the wound itself. Isa pa, sir. Okay, sir. Lalagay po natin yung gauze pad sa sugat niyo po. Di naman masakit no, sir. sir. Lagyan lang po natin ng tape. Make sure na pantay-pantay yung pagkaka-tape ng microphone. Isa pa po, sir. Okay, sir. Huwag na pong maglilikot, sir, ha? Para hindi na po masusugat ulit. Sir, palagi nyo pong linisan yung sugat nyo po para hindi po magka-infection. Magpa-assist po kayo sa magulang nyo, sir. Then, pwede na po kayong magpa-reseta sa doktor, sir. Dahil tapos na po tayong linisan yung sugat nyo. Okay, sir. Thank you po for your cooperation. Sana gumaling na yung sugat nyo. Then, collect the materials that you use and disinfect. Then, discard the used cotton balls and the used ghost pad. And together with the gloves and your PPE. Then, considering that I'm done discarding the materials, then I will perform proper hand hygiene and I'm done.